Hey guys, and welcome to another video. I'm IselTPW. I'm going to make a video today about how to install the Twitch launcher and how to download and install the FTB Feed the Beast mod packs for Minecraft. A number of you have asked on the channel, how can we get on the server? How can we play the games that you play? And can you help out with the Colosseumcraft? Well guys, the answer is yes, you can certainly help out with Colosseumcraft. I'm going to give you all of the details on how to do that. And I'm going to show you as well how to download Twitch/Curse. It's the same launcher. It's now moved over to Twitch. I'm also going to show you how to download mod packs. The one I play on is Feed the Beast Infinity Evolved 1.7.10. As long as you've Minecraft already downloaded on your desktop, and I'm assuming that you have, and it's just the mods that you want to get working on. So let's get cracking. First off, guys, we need to download the Curse launcher, which is typing Curse Launcher into Google. I'm going to click on the first one here. So we are looking to download the Twitch desktop app. This is what we are looking for exactly here, guys. So we're going to download this Twitch desktop app, everything you love about Twitch and more. Download. This is downloading here at the moment. It's going to be a few minutes because of my internet speed. So I'll be back in a few minutes. Hey guys, I'm back, and this is nearly downloaded now, so we're going to open this up as soon as it downloads. There we go, and we will open this. It's asking me to install, so I'm going to install this, and it's installing. And this is going to install the launcher onto your desktop. Login. So I'm going to log in here, guys, into my account. Obviously, I'm not going to let you see my details. So I'm going to log in. You will need to set up a Twitch account as Twitch or a Curse account. Either or. You can log in with Twitch, as I clicked on the link there, or you can log in with Curse. You've got both options. So you can click on the link again here if you've got a Twitch account and log in there. So I'm going to use my details here, guys, and I'll be right back. So guys, I'm logged in there now. This is the app here. I've got my friends list over here, but I've blocked that out. But it gives you a snapshot of the games that you can play on here. So you've got PUBG, League of Legends, Hearthstone, Counter-Strike. But what I'm going to do here is I'm going to go to mods, because we're looking for modded Minecraft, and that's up here. So I'm logging in here. I've already got two mods installed, Minecraft over here. Now, I've already taken the liberty of deleting Feed the Beast Infinity Evolved. Browse all mod packs, and here are all of the Feed the Beast mod packs in Minecraft. So if I didn't make that very, very clear, you would click on mods up here, you go to the Minecraft, and it'll automatically detect whether you've got Minecraft installed or not. You click on the Minecraft. These are the mods that I've already installed, but we're going to browse all mod packs, and this will look at the Feed the Beast mod packs down here. So I'm just going to make this window a little bit bigger, guys, just so you can see. So you got Feed the Beast Beyond, Unstable, Sky Factory, Sky Factory 3, Infinity Light. That is not the Infinity we're looking for. The one we're looking for is FTB Infinity Evolved. It is, last update was Thursday, August 3rd, 2017, and it's game version 1.7.10. That is what we're looking for here. As you can see, it's got 2.3 million downloads, so it's quite popular amongst the Feed the Beast. It's very popular because 1.7.10 is very stable, and so is Feed the Beast Infinity Evolved. We're going to click on the thumbnail over here, and it's going to install. This will again take a few minutes. It's going to install all of the mods. So I'm going to let it install these, and I'll be right back in a few minutes. Okay, and we're back. And as you can see, the mods are nearly downloaded. That's it. It's ready to go. Bring it back in here, going back into Minecraft, and you can see three mod packs installed. So now I have Feed the Beast Infinity Evolved. It's version 3.0.1, which is the most up-to-date version. And I'm going to hit play on this. And because I've played already on Minecraft, I don't need to log in here. When you first log in here, you will need to put in your Minecraft email and password. So you'll need to know that before you log in here. But once you've logged in here, you just click on play. It'll start preparing, it'll start unpacking the jar. What this does is it takes a Java pack from Minecraft and it brings it into the launcher, so it's all launched in one. There is a lot of mods in this mod pack, so it's going to take a few minutes for all of those mods to be installed. As you can see, it's using basically the Forge launcher to load all of these mods into the game. And this can take, depending on how good your processor is, this can take between 5 minutes to 15 minutes. Mine will take about 5 minutes, so I'm going to let this run away and install all of these mods into Minecraft. And just so you know, it does this every time you load this mod pack. So every time you want to load Minecraft, you have to go through this process. There's that many mods, guys, they have to be loaded properly, and that's why you need this launcher from Twitch. So guys, I'll be back in a few minutes when this is ready to set up. Right, I'm back. And all of the mods have nearly been installed now, so it's getting ready to initialize and set up. And here we go. This is the interface for Feed the Beast Infinity Evolved. You've got all of your options here like you would with normal Minecraft. Here is a list of the mods that are in the game. And you can see there's plenty and plenty and plenty of mods there, guys. I'm going to turn down the music here just so that you guys can hear me, because this is a fresh install now. And as you can see, this isn't using my texture pack. I'm going to do another video for you guys how to install the texture pack. I use a Sortex Fanver texture pack, and I'm going to show you how that's done in a separate video. And I'm also going to show you in that video how to install the schematic for the Colosseum, because if you want to come and help to build the Colosseum, you will need the schematic and you will need to know how to use the schematic. So I'm just going to turn all of these down. In the video settings, I'm going to change the brightness all the way up to bright. I do that because when I'm recording, I can see the screen perfectly, but when I play back on a video, the brightness of Minecraft can be quite dark when it's in moody, especially if I'm down in the mines and I'm not putting up torches quick enough. It's just going to be black screen for you guys watching. It'll be fine for me on my screen. That's why I put the brightness way up, so that when I am recording, that you guys can see as well. So if you are recording, that's a good tip. Go into video settings and put the brightness all the way up to full. So you've obviously got the option of a single player and multiplayer. We're playing multiplayer Minecraft, and this is modded Minecraft, so we will now need to add a server, and I'm going to give you, and these links are going to be in the description of this video. So there's a couple of ways that we can go here. I'm going to add a server, and the server name, I'm just going to call this Community Built. And the server address, I'm going to give you two server addresses. There's mc.communitybuilt.net. This will be in the description down below. I'm going to show you the both of these guys, okay? But I'm going to add this two server addresses, and I'll explain what the differences are in just a moment. So this is the first one, and it's loading up here. Community Built. You know it's right when you see the orange logo here with CB in it. Community Built Gaming Lobby. I use this server because it's really stable, and I've really made some really good friends on this server with the admin team, with the owner and the founder. Anyway, that aside, I'm going to add on the other server. So that was mc.communitybuilt.net. This one, and I'm going to change this also to Community Built. This one is inf.communitybuilt.net. So you notice the difference at the beginning. The first one was mc.communitybuilt.net, and this one is inf.communitybuilt.net. Basically, what this does, guys, is you can go directly into Feed the Beast Infinity Evolved, and you can tell the difference here that it has 3.01, or you can go into the lobby. And this is the lobby that's on the server, and I'm going to bring you in there first, just so you can see what it's like in here and why it's here. the server is shut down 3 times a day. I think it's 3 times a day. And it's shut down basically to tidy it up, clean it up, and keep it fresh. If it shuts down and you're in the in-game, if you log in this way, you will be kicked back to the lobby. If you do a direct connect through inf.communitybuilt.net, if you get kicked out when the server goes down, you'll get kicked out directly into your Minecraft screen. If you log in through mc.communitybuilt.net, this is where you will arrive, guys. This is the lobby. I'm going to go to full screen here so that you can see this clearly. This is the lobby, and this is where you've got access to all of the games that they host on this server. And you've got Feed the Beast Infinity Evolved, you've got Feed the Beast Beyond, and you've got Feed the Beast Skyblock. All you need to do to get into Feed the Beast Infinity Evolved is head down the path here, and all you simply have to do is walk through the portal like I'm going to show you right now. And we've got no one, so you can tell here that the server is online because it says it is, and you can tell how many players are online. There's 0 of 50 at the moment. And you literally just walk through the portal like you would with another portal, and it goes to your loading screen. And it just takes about 30 seconds to load in. And as you can see, I've loaded in where I last logged out, and that was at the Colosseum. When you log in, because it'll be your first time, you're going to log in at spawn. And this is spawn. This is where you will start the game. I'm back home again, guys, and now I'm going to log out, and I'm going to show you the difference between... That was logging in through mc.communitybuilt.net. The only difference between logging in with the lobby one and Infinity is that when you log in, and I pressed join server there, it brings you straight into the game and it doesn't bring you into the lobby. I prefer just clicking directly in, to be honest with you. And that's pretty much it, guys. As you can see down here, we have 184 mods. It's Minecraft 1.7.10 and it's Infinity Evolved 3.0.1. That's how you download Twitch, that's how you download the game, and I hope that this was really useful for you. So guys, that's it from me. I really hope that you enjoyed this video and this tutorial. This is my first tutorial, to be honest with you. I will do a tutorial of the resource pack, the texture pack, and also for the schematic for the Colosseum if that's something you want to get involved in. But until then, and as always, I'll see you in the next video. Bye!